It's Tipsy Tuesday at 383 Design Studio. Join our digital design guru for today's Adobe Illustrator for Fashion quick tip. So I was working with a design group recently, and they're all pretty seasoned vets, and we started talking about brushes. And what I've realized from teaching and from freelancing is that most people still don't really understand how to color brushes properly. So let's break down the colorization methods in Illustrator once and for all. And then I'll give you my overall assessment of how best to use them on your sketches. There are four colorization methods for brushes: none, tints, tints and shades, and hue shift. The method you choose along with the stroke color determine the color of the brush. Set the method to none, and no matter what the stroke color is, the brush will always stay the same color as the original art. Set it to tints, and black art becomes the same color as the stroke color, while lighter colors become tones of the stroke color. With tints and shades, black and white art stay as is, while other colors in the art become a tint of the current stroke color. And lastly, choosing hue shift makes the most prominent color in the art the key color, and all other colors become related colors. And in case you forget any of that, Illustrator has a little tips menu, that little light bulb next to the colorization methods, to help you remember. So now that you know how the colorization methods work, what does that all mean to you, the apparel or footwear or accessories designer using brushes every day? Well, here's my top four suggestions. Number one, for single color artwork like stitches, cables, ribs, make sure the artwork is black. Number two, use tints with your single color artwork to ensure that the color of your brush will exactly match the stroke color. Number three, for two-color artwork, use black and white. White-filled artwork outlined with a black stroke. And number four, use hue shift with your two-color art and your brush will be filled with your stroke color and outlined in black. Unfortunately, for any brush that is more than two colors, like a multicolored taping, the only way to predict the exact colors is to make a separate brush for each colorway. But hey, to be able to create one cover stitch brush and reuse it over and over again throughout a 50-piece collection just by changing the stroke color was a huge time saver to that design team. I hope you guys feel the same way. That's your tip for today. I'm Mikkel, and as always, I thank you so much for watching. Have a great week, and I'll see you on 7th Avenue. Thank you.